工业化进程创造了前所未有的物质财富，也产生了难以弥补的生态创伤。
Resources such as land, water, and energy are limited. Fossil fuels, for example, will run out in hundreds of years, if not sooner, if we continue to burn at the current rate. So, how do we deal with the challenge? The Chinese asked a similar question 1,000 years ago, when the Tang Emperor in the 8th century needed to control excessive land use. The solution is to use resources with restraints and moderation.
取之有度, 用之有节, 是生态文明的真谛。 我们要倡导 简约适度, 绿色低碳的 生活方式, 拒绝奢华和浪费, 形成文明健康的 生活风尚。
The idea of restraint and moderation has survived and taken on new meanings in modern time. Now let's meet Lawrence Brown to talk about the original text,
取之有度, 用之有节,
and its modern manifestation. Hi, Lawrence.
Hey.
How was your day?
Good, really good.
Good to see
How
you.
How are things today?
It's great. And today I invited you to talk about a quotation the Chinese leader used in his speeches about balance between nature and humans. It is taken from a book named 资治通鉴. Have you ever read the book?
Heard of the book? I have a copy of 资治通鉴.
What do you know about it?
Well, it was, I believe, written in the Song Dynasty, and it covered 16 different dynasties. And it's really a guidebook that you can see a continuum of cultural, traditional understanding of leadership and how to lead a nation through this book.
And the quotation itself means you don't have to push against nature too harsh. You have to use resources with restraints and moderations. What do you think of this philosophy and this value?
This is core to Chinese culture. 天然合一 in Chinese.
So in really, harmony with nature for
exactly,
humans.
Exactly. We humans are just a conduit between the earth and the sky.
We think about economic policies. This is a result of that. We use too much resources. We ask too much from nature. And then we lost our land and ponds and lakes.
I think what's happening now at a national level is there is a total consideration of how we need to rebalance the economy. And here I think we could see with President Xi and the direction being taken under the ecological civilization policy that there is an enormous amount of investment now going into regridding the grid and shifting away from fossil fuels to green energy within a very short time. And that's a kind of huge decision, political will to rebalance the environment.
If you put the Chinese context against, say, Western context, what is the difference behind the thinking and the value systems between nature and man?
I think what we need to look at is the fundamental difference between Western thinking and Asian thinking on this value issue. Western thinking, since around the time of the Middle Ages, adopted a duality. And I think Asian thinking traditionally works around the concept of the yin and the yang. The yin and the yang are not opposites, because ultimately it's about balance, it's about a middle way, so that the energy track, the whole momentum of things is always going forward, but going forward in balance with nature.
When it comes to policies, it still needs the people to support the governments in terms of economic rebalancing, ecological culture. Do you think that is happening? Do the two sides meet in the middle?
Well, I think this is a very important aspect of the ecological civilization policy. And first of all, if we're going to be going into a new era of green energy, everything from law to engineering to city planning, to industrial use to waste management, everything needs to be rethought. And that has to go into the educational system. It's already being implemented down to the neighborhood level. And of course, with that is a higher awareness for people. And fortunately, with China's 5,000 years of cultural continuity of man being part of nature and understanding that, I think it's not difficult to get everybody on the same page.
Thank you so much, Lawrence.
The philosophy of restraints and moderation has resonated throughout Chinese history.
仰望夜空, 繁星闪烁, 地球是全人类赖以生存的唯一家园, 我们要像保护自己的眼睛一样, 保护生态环境, 像对待生命一样, 对待生态环境。